Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on symptoms of a faulty PCV valve. PCV stands for Positive Crankcase Ventilation, so the PCV valve simply refers to the Positive Crankcase Ventilation valve. So what does a PCV valve do exactly? To explain that, it's important to preface this with the fact that all internal combustion engines produce some degree of blow-by gases, so these are gases that actually make it past the piston rings and down into the crankcase of the engine. When those gases end up in the crankcase, that causes pressures to build up and can also allow moisture, predominantly water vapor and fuel, into the crankcase, which can then mix with oil and dilute the oil. So ultimately, there needs to be a way to ventilate or rid the crankcase of those excess pressures and gases. That is exactly what the PCV valve is designed to do. However, simply venting this back to the atmosphere would lead to an increase in harmful emissions. So basically, the positive crankcase ventilation system and valve vent those crankcase gases back into the intake tract and ultimately back into the engine where they can be burned as a part of normal operation. Now, a faulty PCV valve is one of the most common issues with the positive crankcase ventilation system. There are a couple different ways in which the PCV valve can become faulty, and that is predominantly with the valve being stuck open or becoming stuck closed. It can also become clogged. For the purpose of this video, just kind of including that in with being closed, because a clogged valve will act just as a valve that is stuck closed. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump into some of the most common signs and symptoms of a faulty PCV valve. Symptom number one for a bad PCV valve, we have oil consumption. This is most common when the PCV valve fails in a stuck open position. This allows the crankcase ventilation system to actually pull excess pressure from the crankcase during high vacuum situations. High vacuum situations, the valve should be closed and would normally be closed, but if it's stuck open, oil can actually be pulled from the crankcase into the engine and be burned off by the cylinders. So this will result in the engine not only consuming oil, but you may also notice a bluish white smoke from the exhaust. Moving on to symptom number two, we have rough idle, stuttering, poor performance, and poor engine operation in general. So this is something that, again, also happens when the PCV valve fails in a stuck open position. When that occurs, again, this excess pressure, it allows the engine to pull in additional air, which can throw off your air fuel ratios, which can lead to a whole host of other issues, including rough idle, stuttering, hesitation, engine misfires, and just poor overall operation of the engine. Moving on to symptom number three of a bad or faulty PCV valve, we have the check engine light. This can be a symptom of either a stuck open or stuck closed valve or a clogged valve, really any issues with the positive crankcase ventilation system. So most modern cars and engines have ECUs or computers that are capable of monitoring the positive crankcase ventilation system. Any problems with the PCV system on most modern engines can trigger the check engine light and have a code associated with the PCV system. Now, there are also some other things that can trigger the check engine light, as I mentioned with the second symptom of rough idle and poor engine operation. If your air fuel ratios are out of line or the engine is misfiring, that can also trigger fault codes, which will in turn trigger the check engine light. But ultimately, the PCV system can trigger the fault code and check engine light directly, or it may be something else like misfires or poor air fuel ratios that are ultimately triggering the check engine light. And that really just depends on the vehicle. Not all vehicles do monitor the PCV system, especially on older vehicles, but most modern engines from 2010 up should monitor the PCV system. So any issues there, again, should trigger that check engine light and an associated fault code stored within the computer. Moving on to symptom number four for a faulty positive crankcase ventilation valve, we have oil leaks. Oil leaks are something that tend to occur when the valve is clogged or fails in a closed position. And the reason for that is when the valve is open, that's when it's actually ventilating the gases and the pressure out of the crankcase. So when the valve is stuck shut, pressure is allowed to build up in the crankcase of the engine, which ultimately that pressure is going to escape somewhere, and the easiest way for that pressure to try to escape the engine is out of gaskets, O-ring, seals, any of those rubber components sealing the engine and preventing oil leaks. So that buildup of pressure will ultimately result in that oil seeping past those gaskets, seals, O-rings, etc. Last but not least, our fifth symptom for a faulty PCV valve is sludge buildup or sludge accumulation in the engine. This is something that also occurs with a PCV valve that is stuck shut or clogged. The reason for that is, again, the PCV valve is ventilating these gases from the crankcase. These gases tend to contain unburnt fuel as well as water vapors. And so when that is allowed in the crankcase and cannot be ventilated, ultimately, that can mix with the oil, cause oil dilution, and then that poor oil quality will then start building up and accumulating throughout the engine, which is known as sludge or sludge buildup. So if you're running into that, can certainly be a common symptom that you do have a clogged or stuck shut PCV valve. That wraps up the most common symptoms for a faulty PCV valve. In summary, again, symptoms can vary depending on whether that valve fails in a stuck open or stuck closed position. When the valve fails in a stuck open position, you'll tend to notice symptoms more along the lines of oil consumption, rough idle, poor overall performance of the engine, bluish gray smoke from the exhaust. Again, when the oil is being consumed, it's then being burned off in the cylinders, which produces that bluish gray smoke from the exhaust. And then lastly, the check engine light, which can affect both. So moving on to the PCV valve failing in the closed position or it being clogged. With this, you'll typically notice symptoms more along the lines of oil leak due to the buildup of pressure causing oil to seep past gaskets, O-rings, and seals, and also sludge accumulation in the engine due to unburnt fuel and water vapors mixing with the oil, and once again, the check engine light. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.